हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। हाय, हाउ आर यू ऑल गोइंग? कैन यू हियर मी? गुड मॉर्निंग अभिराम। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई होप आई एम विजिबल एंड ऑडिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू। यस और नो? ग्रेट, लेट मी सी यू ऑल इन द क्लास। अभिराम इज देयर, सूर्या आई थिंक न्यू। ओके, आई थिंक सम ऑफ यू माइट हैव गॉन टू द क्लास एज वेल। ओके, वी स्टार्ट विथ न्यूटन लॉज ऑफ मोशन, लेक्चर नंबर 16 टूडे। इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड आवर कंस्ट्रेंड मोशन। आवर मेजर पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर वॉज कंस्ट्रेंड मोशन। ओह यस, एग्जाम, आई फॉरगॉट अबाउट द एग्जाम। Totally forget about the exam. Yes, Abhiram, how was the exam today, this year? How much this week, Sunday? Totally forgot about it. It was easy. Your first paper, and the topic has to be easy. It went good. That is great. What was your score, Abhiram, in that? Okay, so you are so happy with 165 in physics. Great. Out of 180, I guess, 45. Okay. So I guess the paper was pretty simple. From your 403 overall, Abhiram, you need to improve on your overall score. Getting 165 here, but you should improve on the overall score. MA physics was easy. Trust me, beta, it was not easy. This is the level of question that come in JE, not JE, in NEET. I can't help it. This is the level of question that come. Whatever I am telling you is of a very high level. Now, why do I teach you at a higher level and the papers are not so much up to that level? It's because of the simple fact that your NEET ka exam is way below the level that I am teaching you. If I am teaching you at this level, the NEET exam is somewhere here. You see? So much of difference. In fact, the last paper, not this one, the last paper that I gave you, that was almost of the level of JEE mains, maybe above that. Yeah, it was very tough. So I'll keep on doing this so that I keep you on your toes. Some papers would be of the level of NEET. I will not give you any paper which is below the level of NEET. No, that will not be the case. That is not the case anywhere, anytime. No paper will be below the level of NEET. You'll only get paper higher than the level of NEET, and it will go up till the JEE mains level. Sometimes maybe one or two questions I will put for the advanced level as well. This is just for you to understand. See, you have to understand one thing, Abhiram, and all the students over there. Can you just raise hand that you are listening to me? Surya, Vasant, Vishal. Abhiram is definitely listening to me. What about the others? Vishal, Surya? Yeah. Vishal, Surya, Vasant? Vishal, Surya, Vasant? Are you listening to me? So, remember one thing that I am telling you. In an examination hall, when you are sitting, when you are going to sit for your exam 2 years from now, you can't predict. See, it's a computer-based test, or it may be a paper-based test as well. I don't know whether they change the pattern or not. Any question can come. Now, if you are thinking in your head that I will score 170 or 150 in physics, and you find the physics ka paper tough, don't get disheartened. There might be one or two questions always, maybe three or four, maximum four. They cannot give you more than four tough questions, four or five, unless until they have gone insane. Those four or five questions could be in the very beginning. And for you, you must understand that there are 45 questions. And you should be careful in attempting those questions. That is why I'll always put one or two questions which will be difficult, maybe very difficult. so that you understand that this is the question that you should leave in the first attempt and you should not try. You can try it later when you have time and you are left with some time at your hands. So in any paper, whether it is JEE Mains or Advanced or NEET, why I am checking the NEET setting or checking the chat. Okay. No matter which exam you are sitting for here or in your college or your MBA exam or wherever, it's important that you understand which question you can solve and which question you can't. You must understand this. That is why you have to be selective. Abhiram is very happy today, 165. I am also very happy that you know the basic fundamentals. That's great. These are the questions that will come in your examination on, and you will be surprised. And maybe some of these will be appearing in your NEET. But it might be tougher as well. So as I tell you, as I keep on telling you, every week, every month, that paper you are giving, save it. Same questions will come in your exam. And I will have a band of, band of marks. If you are always in those band, I can assure you that you will be remaining in the same band in your final exam whenever or wherever it happens. So for Abhiram, because he is giving all the exams sincerely, I think the lowest he has got is around 135. And this is the highest that he has got, 165. So that is his bandwidth. That is where Abhiram is working right now. I don't know about others because I don't know their marks. And the other students, Niharika, Tanu, I don't think they are there in the class. Lowest was 113. Okay, Abhiram, I missed it. I remember 130 something. Okay, so basically you have a band. Now, if you keep consistently hitting that band, you can be assured that you will be there in that band in your final exam. Okay, don't get very happy with your marks. Don't get overexcited, because if you get overexcited, you will get overconfident. If you get overconfident, that's not good. Don't get very disheartened. If you get, Abhiram also got 113. Don't get very disheartened by marks, because maybe that paper was tough. Maybe you were not prepared. And remember, please remember one thing. The test that you're giving right now are only for a very, very small portion of the chapter of the course. Now, in the final exam, that portion where Abhiram has got 113 or Abhiram has got 165 or Niharika or Tanu or Vasant or anyone has scored even 180, maybe not even a single question come from that portion. So that 180 actually becomes zero. Or that 100 becomes zero. Don't get overexcited. Don't get over sad. Keep your performance in a band. Keep a track of all these questions that I am giving you. I am giving you almost all possible questions that are possible that can come in JEE Mains according to my knowledge. I'm giving you each and every question. So I keep on giving you questions until I am sure that you are done. I'm now sure that I have done almost all the questions that are possible in 2D motion, relative motion. I know that I've given you almost all questions. That's why I have moved on to Newton's laws of motion. But remember, there will be questions that are still going to come from the previous topics, and that will start very soon. So whenever I tell you, or whenever you give an exam, if I tell you the course is Newton's laws of motion, that does not mean that questions will only come from Newton's laws of motion. There might be questions which are not from Newton's laws of motion, but from the previous chapters. So be ready. Don't get over complacent. Well, that is my style. My style of revision. My style of working. Just give me a minute. I'll just get my water bottle. Just give me a minute. I'm just feeling thirsty. Just give me a minute. Okay, I'm back. So, Newton's laws of motion, lecture 16. Let us start the lecture. Just a minute. I'm getting very thirsty these days. I don't know why. Chalo. Start karte. I think we had already done that weighing machine. And we had done a few questions on weighing machine. In the weighing machine, we found out that the reading in the weighing machine or the reading in the machine is nothing but the normal reaction between the person and the machine. Do you remember that? Can you please raise your hands that the reading in the machine, weighing machine, was the normal reaction between what? Abhira, normal reaction between what? For the weighing machine, do you remember? Weighing machine, normal reaction between what? Normal reaction between what? The reading in the weighing machine is what? Biram, Vasant, are you there in the class, beta? Vijayalakshmi, Surya, what is the reading in the weighing machine? Do you remember? Reading in the weighing machine, I am not getting answer. Reading in the weighing machine is what? You are standing on a weighing machine. If a person is standing on the weighing machine, how do you get the reading in the weighing machine? We get the reading in the weighing machine by finding out the normal reaction between the person and the machine. Now, the next thing that we are going to start today is the next type of force. We have seen gravitational force, we have normal reaction force, friction is left, going to come very soon now. We have seen gravitational force, normal reaction force, tension in the string. The next one, and you can always expect in NEET a question on this, is spring force. What is this spring force? Anyone has any idea about this spring force? Welcome to the stage. Please let me know your thoughts. What are your thoughts on spring force? What do you understand by spring force? Am I audible and visible to all of you? I feel that I am not audible or visible. I am not getting any responses from anyone. Am I audible? Am I visible? Vashan, Surya, Vishal, Abhiram. Okay. What do you mean by this spring force? Everyone has experienced this spring force at some point in your life. You must have played around with springs. Spring is one thing that fascinates a lot of us as kids. Now, one end, let us assume that we have fixed one end of the spring. That will be the case in most of the cases. We have fixed one end of the spring, and then this is a spring in its normal state. We call it unstretched normal length of the spring. Let us say that the normal length of the spring is L naught. This is the length of the spring when it is not stretched or it is not compressed. When the string is not compressed or when the string is not stretched, what is the force in the string? The force in the string in that case is definitely zero. We all understand it. Yes or no? Yes or no? But if I take a case where I'm going to change the length of the spring, how I'm going to change the length of the spring? For example, I extend it. Now I've extended it. And now the length becomes L0 plus X. So I have extended it from its normal length. I have increased its length. I have extended it. Remember, one end of the spring is fixed and I am extending the spring. What happens now? 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 If you have extended this spring by X, the length has become L naught plus X. What happens now? You will see that the spring will try to come back to its original position. So a force will start to act on the spring in this direction. Spring will try to come back to its original position. We have found out that the force in this spring, which in the opposite direction, is K multiplied by X, where this K, remember, is a constant, which is known as the spring constant. Where K is a constant, which is known as the spring constant, which is normally given to us. A very stiff spring will have very high spring constant. There used to be springs in small ball pens that were used to tuck, 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 tuck. That spring was easy to compress and easy to extend. For those springs, the spring constant K is very less. You might have also seen a very big spring. If you have seen the train ka dabba, coach, bogie of a train. Now this bogie of a train, if you look at it, it also has big, big springs. That springs are very hard to press. They only get pressed when a lot of people sit on it. The suspension of your car, if you have a look behind the wheels of the car, just behind the wheels, you will see a big spring. It gets compressed. In your bike, you will see them on the outer side, red, blue colors of spring. If you have cycle, even the seats of the cycle and the handle of the cycle have springs. If the spring is hard to compress, K is very high. If it is soft to compress, K is very less. Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand that you understand this? Don't understand this? Okay. Now, remember, when the spring is in its normal length, it is not stretched or it is not extended or compressed, the force is zero. Therefore, we call this as mean position. Mean position. Or you can also call it the equilibrium position. Equilibrium position. Do you understand the meaning of the term equilibrium here? Equilibrium means force is zero. Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand? So when the spring in its natural length, there is no force acting on the spring or any body which is attached to the spring. That position is known as its mean position or its equilibrium position. Do we understand this? New terms are coming. And you must be very confident about these terms. Yes or no? Do we understand this? Okay. Now, if I mark this equilibrium position here, let us say this is the mean MP. MP meaning mean position or equilibrium position. Now, if you look at this, this would be the extension in the spring. This would be the extension in the spring. Remember, the difference between spring and string. The difference is for T and P. T standing for tension and P standing for nothing. String and spring. String does not get compressed, does not get extended. The length of the string always remains constant. But the length of the spring is not constant. It can get compressed, it can get extended. Here it is getting extended. And the direction of extension is in this direction. From the mean position, it is extended like this. The blue one, the extension is in this direction. But if you look at the force is in the opposite direction. That means if you extend the spring like this, spring will exert force like this. Am I clear? The direction of force in the spring is always opposite to how that spring has changed its length. If it is getting extended in this direction, it will exert force. It will try to come back to its original position in this direction. So force will be opposite. Now, since the force is opposite, if you want to write it in the vector form, I will write it like this. F vector is minus kx vector. Do you get my point? I can write it vectorly like this, or simply, if I'm not using vectors, if I call one as positive, the other becomes negative. So I can just put a negative sign over here and my thing is resolved. Do we understand this? Why I put a negative sign over here? Because x is in this direction, force is in this direction. Yes or no? Do we understand this? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this, sir? The spring will always exert force in the opposite direction to where it has been extended or compressed. If we take the reverse case where the spring is compressed, so x will be like this. The force that the spring will exert will be like this. So again, I can say F is minus kx because x from the mean position, remember, this x is always calculated from where? Remember, it is always calculated from the mean position. From the position where length of the spring is its natural length. I would need a raise of hands so that I can move any further. Please let me know if you have understood this. Yes or no? Spring force is what we are discussing right now. And we have seen spring will exert force on any body which is attached to it. If it is extended, it will exert force in the opposite direction. If it is compressed, it will exert force in the opposite direction still. Shall we move ahead? Now see. Let us imagine that I have a wall and a block and a thing, floor. I have a spring and it is attached to a block of mass M. The natural length of the spring is like this, L0, and it has been extended. Oh, I made it very small. Let me make it a bit larger. Otherwise, it will not make much sense. Okay, let us say that the length of the spring is L0 here. And now, as you can see, it is extended by X. The spring constant of this spring is K. Now, I am asking you a simple question. Question number one, draw the free body diagram of block M. Number two, find the value of normal reaction and Fs. What is Fs? F means force, S means spring, force exerted by spring, Fs. And what is the acceleration of the block? So you have to draw the free body diagram of M, find the value of normal reaction, spring force, and A. You will have 2 minutes. Think about this. If you can do this question in the first attempt, you have understood spring. Congratulations. I'll give you 2 minutes. Has anyone got the answer for this? Has anyone got the answer for this? No one? Okay. Then I'll do it. How to do it? What is new? New thing is only one extra force is there. Rest everything remains same. Step number one. Draw a sketch. Sketch is there. Step number two. Isolate the body. Only one body. What to isolate? Step number three. Draw the free body diagram. Let us start. Let us start with the weight of the body. Oops, wrong color. Weight of the body is mg, which is downwards. Normal reaction is n, which is upwards. Nothing has changed over here. The only thing that has changed that there is no string but spring. And as you can see, spring is extended. So it will try to pull the block here. So the force on the block will be in this direction. Yes or no? That will be the force F. Do we understand this force F? This is Fs, force in the spring. Can I have some raise hand that we understand this? Fs. Now, what is the value of this Fs? The value of this Fs will be equal to K into X. I have not put the minus sign because I already know the direction is backwards. Minus sign only indicates the direction. I just write Fs as KX. X is like this. F is like this, so minus sign is already there. Yes or no? Raise hand will give me more confidence that we have understood this. Now what I'm going to do, step number one is done, two is done, three done. Now I will take my axis, y-axis. There is no motion along y-axis. Upward force N should be equal to downward force mg. So my first equation becomes N equates mg. Do we understand this, everyone? N equates mg. That becomes my first equation coming from the y-axis. Yes or no? I'm not getting any responses. I'm feeling very disheartened. I'm not getting any responses from anyone. I hope everyone is awake. Everyone is live and awake. starting with Vasant, Surya, Vishal, Abhiram, you're all there, right? Okay. N becomes equal to mg. So let us see how many questions I have answered. N is already done. N is equal to mg. Spring force Fs is equal to k into x. K is known, x is known. So this is also done. The only thing that remains is to get the value of a, acceleration. How do I get the value of a, which is acceleration? Again, I move on to the next step. If I look at the free body diagram of this body in the blue side, oops, the color did not change. Still pink. Okay, what has happened here? Okay, getting something. Okay, now change. Look at the blue one. Fs is this side. There is no force on this side. Fs is this side. There is no force on this side. So there is only one direction in which this block can accelerate. Fs is this side. There is no force on this side. So this block, wrong color, yeah. What is happening with the colors here? So this block can only accelerate this side. Let us call the acceleration as A. The color is not changing. I don't know why. Acceleration is A on this side. Something has happened now. So now the color has changed. So acceleration is like this on this side. And something is happening. Something is not working here. I'll try to shift it. So acceleration is this side. Spring force is this side, so Fs. I must change this one because it is not working. So let me move on to this one. Since things are not working on that one, let us move on this one. Okay. So what do I have here? I have Fs on this side. Fs on this side. That must be equal to M into A. Yes or no? Do we understand this? Fs must be equal to M into A. Now Fs, the value is K into X. K into X shall be equal to M into A. That implies A will be equal to KX by M. Am I clear? Can I have some raise hand that we understand this, sir? Do we understand it? So that was our, that is what we are looking at here. Something is not working. So your acceleration is KX by M. Do we understand this? Can I give you another question that you will be able to solve? Is this question clear to you, everyone? Can I now give you a different question? Are we ready? So this is the question that you are now having. Instead of one block, there are two blocks. Don't get frightened. Stay calm. Two blocks are connected by spring of a natural length 2 meters. The force constant of the spring is, force constant means K. The value of K of the spring is 200 newton per meter. Find the spring force in the following situations. Can you help? Can you solve this? A is not asked, beta. They are only asked the spring force. Can you get me the answer for the spring force? So, when you have these two blocks, and in first case, you are moving them by 0.5 and 0.5 in the same direction, in the same direction. So, what will not change, Abhiram? Yes, that is what I was asking you. What will not change here? What will not change? The spring force. No, that's not right, Beta. It's not right to say that. The length of the spring will not change. The length of the spring will remain same. When the length of the spring remains same, there is no extension or there is no contraction in the spring. If there is no extension or no contraction in the spring, there is no spring force. So in this case, the force in the spring is zero. Case number one, solved. Congratulations. Do we understand this? The reason, Abhiram, reason is important. No extension or no compression, and hence the spring force is zero. Can you now tell me the answer in case number two? Case number two means they are moving in opposite directions. They are moving in opposite directions. What will be the answer in this case? When they are moving in the opposite direction, let me make it with the black thing so that they look different. The black diagram. We are on the black diagram. This one, mm. Now it is moved like here, 0.5. And it is moved like here, 0.5. So effectively, what is happening to the spring? Anyone? Spring will contract. Yes, Abhiram, spring will contract by how much? By how much spring contract? If you understand this, by 1 meter, yes. By 1 meter, yes. So what will be the force in the spring? Force in the spring is always K multiplied by X. K multiplied by X. K is 200. X is 1 meter. So 200 multiplied by 1. If it's 1 centimeter, 0.01. If it's 1 meter, is 1. 200 newtons. 200 newtons would be the force. If you got the answer, please raise your hands. Did you get the answer? Please raise your hands. Yes. Important thing here is also to understand what is the direction of force. Remember, force is a vector quantity. Just do not become happy by writing the value of force. You have to also understand the direction of force, which I am going to draw now by the red ink. What will be the direction of force? Let us say direction on flow force on this block. The red dot I have drawn. What will be the direction of force? The force is definitely 200 newtons. What is the direction of force on this block? Please tell me the answer. The direction of force on this block, which is 200 newtons, will be like this. Yes or no? Well done. Let us talk about the direction of force on this block, the second block, which is on the left-hand side. What will be the direction of force on this one? It will be like this, 200. 200 on this block, this side. 200 on the other block, this side. So if I say the net force is zero. Remember this, net force is zero. It's an internal force here. That is why it is zero. Internal, external. I'll tell you, don't worry. Do we understand this? Can I have some raised hand that we understand this, sir? Abhiram seems to have understood this. What about others? I'm not getting any response from the others. I hope you are able to listen. You're watching me and you are having the screen on and you can see the screen. Let us now solve one more problem to end this discussion for today. And this problem that we are going to solve is like this. Now, instead of the block kept on a floor, the block is hanging. The spring constant of this spring is K. Now, I hang this block and this system or this block is at rest. I can call it at rest or I can call it at equilibrium. Both are same things. Equilibrium means force is zero. Rest also means that in this case, force is zero. Now, first question I'm going to ask you, everyone, common sense. Physics is all about common sense. If you have common sense, you know physics and you can clear need. You can become a doctor. I'll be needing all you doctors because when you all graduate, become MBBS, become MD, become DM, will take around 10, 12, 15 years. I would be needing a lot of you doctors. But at that time, I will be needing a lot of medical care. So whatever I'm doing is for myself, my own self. Why was I telling you this? Anyways, I forgot. The first question, common sense. I was talking about common sense. You can clear need with common sense. Now, but common sense tell me, if I hang a block like this from a spring, and the block is at rest or in equilibrium, is the spring in its natural length, or is the spring compressed, or is the spring extended? Simple question. I hang a block by a spring. The block is in equilibrium or at rest. Is the spring in its natural length? Is the spring extended, or is the spring compressed? This case is different from the case where the block was kept like this. When the block was kept like this, the equilibrium position was when the block or the spring is at its natural length. This was the equilibrium position. Do we understand this, what I am telling you? This is the equilibrium position. This is the equilibrium position when the spring is in its natural length. I'm asking the same question here. The block is in equilibrium. It's not good for me to write rest, so I'll just take out rest. The block is in equilibrium. My question to you is, simple question. Is the spring extended? Is the spring compressed? Or is the spring in its natural length? Who will tell me the answer? Common sense. The spring would definitely be extended. Yes, Abhiram, the spring would be definitely extended. So, if the natural length of the spring is L naught, the natural length of the spring is L naught, it would be extended by some length. Let me call this as X naught. So now this becomes its mean position. It will be extended by mean position or equilibrium position will be when the spring would be extended by X naught. Well done. Good common sense. Can you tell me the value of this X naught? Can you tell me the value of this X naught? That is the last question. To give you an idea of how spring and spring force work, what type of questions you can expect here, only two types. Either the block is on ground like this, or the block is hanging. Only two questions, two varieties, nothing else. 2 minutes, think. I always tell you, if you can solve the question in the first case, when I was very surprised that in the JD class, I gave a question on constraint, and everyone was able to solve it in the first go, that means they've understood it. So I don't have to ask any other question. What is the value of X naught? How will I find the value of X naught? That is the most important question, not the value of X naught. I always tell you, and I always keep on telling you, whatever happens. The process is important. How you solve the problem, how you think of solving the problem, that is important, not the result. Result is not in our hand, karma is in our hand. Fell is not in our hand. It's in the hand of the Almighty who is sitting over there. You do your karma. The karma is what is important. To try is important. What you're thinking is important. The answer is not. No answers are right. No answers are wrong. Maybe what answer you give, you think it is wrong. In some universe, it is correct. And there are multiple universes here. Okay. How do I do about it? How do I go about it? I have only one tariqa of solving any damn question on Newton's law or any question that comes from here on. Only one tariqa I have got. Number one step, sketch. Number two, isolate the body. Nothing is there to isolate. Number three, draw the free body diagram. Let us draw the free body diagram. Start with our gravitational force, mg, always vertically downwards, can't help it. Mg is trying to pull it down. But as soon as it pulls it down, the spring gets extended and spring starts to exert a force. That force will be in the opposite direction, Fs. That is in the opposite direction, Fs. Now it is given and I can't highlight it. Because if I highlight it with this, I don't know how to do it. No option of highlighting it. So I'll just draw the green one. The block is in equilibrium, remember. So this Fs, which is the upward force, along y-axis, should be equal to mg, which is the downward force along x-axis, along y-axis, as simple as that. Fs has to be equal to mg. Now, when Fs equals to mg, what is Fs? K multiplied by x naught. X naught is the extension in the spring. Ting, 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 it comes from here. That must be equal to mg from here. You can find the value of X naught. Let me put it here. X naught will be equal to mg by k. Remember this. This X naught is going to come in almost all problems where a block is hanging. Now the question that I ask, why are you thinking on the same line? If you were thinking on the same line, great. The end result doesn't matter. If you are thinking correctly, in this universe, it is done in this way. Maybe the thought that you had or relevant in some other universe, and remember, trust me, that universe exists. Whatever thought, I mean, I'm developing this theory that whatever thought comes to a human mind, it is valid, it is true. But may not be in this universe. In this universe, it may look science fiction. But in some other universe, it is true. Sometimes you dream. You have all sorts of weird dreams. You dream that you are somewhere there doing something else. It might be correct. It will be correct. I have dreams that, you know, I'm in the Air Force and flying a Sukhoi or a Rafale. Because there was one point in time I was selected in ND and I did not go because my dad did not allow me to go. If I would have been there, I would have surely been flying some of these jets because I would have been selected in Air Force. So there is one universe probably where my father allowed me to go to NDA and I got selected and I'm still flying that plane there. Maybe I was flying a MiG and it crashed and I'm still not there in that universe. But that universe exists and I know that it exists. Every thought that you have is true in some way or the other, some universe or the other. I believe it. No thought is stupid. Every thought makes sense. And to me, every thought makes sense. And I think in that way. If you're thinking in this way, this thought is valid in this universe. And this is the universe that we live in. And it's a good universe to live in, trust me. Where it is, MG? Simple. Simple. This is the simplest universe. I've read it somewhere that this is the simplest possible universe that we are living in. So let us live in the simplest possible universe. And the value of X naught here is MG by K. Do you understand this? Can I have some raise hands? That we have understood this. Well done, Abhiram. So I'll wind off today's class on this note. No thought is stupid. Every thought is valid. May not be in this universe. Look for a universe where it is valid, and I'm sure you can find it out. Take care. Bye-bye. If you have any thoughts, please let me know. Any doubts, please let me know. Bye for now. I'll put the PDF in the thing, and I hope that you can see it. Take care. Bye-bye. Sayonara.